हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, जय भारत। वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास ऑफ रवि सर, द इजियर एंड बेटर वे टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 9 टू 12, इंक्लूडिंग जेई मेंस एंड एडवांस मैथमेटिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ टू फाइंड आउट HCF यूजिंग यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा। यू नो दैट स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा वी हैव स्टडीड यूक्लिड डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम। We have learned that how to find out GCD or HCF of two integer or two more than two integers. Students, in our today's video lecture, we are going to study very basic concepts about mathematics, that is LCM and HCF. Students, all these things about LCM and HCF you have studied in your very primary classes also. Still, we are going to discuss in a little bit advanced manner. So first of all, I want to give few brief informations regarding LCM and HCF. Students, you know that LCM, what is LCM? LCM means smallest common multiple. Whenever you are discussing about LCM, you will have to keep it in mind that you will have to just focus on to the multiple. On HCF, HCF students stand for highest common factor. Whenever you are discussing about HCF, you will have to keep it in mind that you will have to focus on the factor. Students, multiple. Multiple of any integers that appears in its timetable. For example, if you are reading the timetable of 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, all these things are multiple of 3. Okay, whenever you are discussing about factor, suppose you are considering a number 36. It means factor means students, a number that divides another number without giving remainder 0. Students, whenever you are discussing about factor of any integer that divides the integers with no remainder, right? Suppose an example 36. If 36 is divided by 1, so what will be the remainder? Obviously the remainder will be 0. If 36 is to be divided by 2, it goes 18 times, obviously once again remainder will be 0. If 36 is to be divided by 3, remainder will be 0. 36 will be divided by 4, remainder will be 0. It means all these are 1, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18, even 36 are the factor of 36. Okay? Students, generally LCM and HCF are used to do the comparison between two integers. Students, LCM and HCF having different uses. When something is repeating again and again, then you will have to use LCM. While when you want to split something in a smaller part, you will have to use HCF. If you are purchasing multiple items, in that questions you will have to find out LCM. Okay? If you are distributing a certain thing amongst a particular person, you will have to find out HCF. LCM generally students use whenever something will meet once again, then you will have to find out LCM. And HCF is you will have to arrange something in a particularly group in a row or column. Okay students, let us see how to find out LCM and HCF. Suppose students, I am giving an example that first question, suppose 90 and 60. Suppose you having two integers 90 and 60 and you want to find out LCM and HCF of these two integers. So students, in our previous video lecture you have studied how to factorize, how to do the tree factorization to get the particular factor of that integers. Okay, let us repeat once again students. Suppose you having the number 90, 90 is to be divided by 2, right? If 90 is to be divided by 2, here you are getting 45. Again students, 45 will be divided by 3. Students, here you are getting 15. 15 is to be divided by 3. Here you are getting what? 5. Okay students, so 90 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Right? And 60. Let us do the prime factorization of 60. 60 is to be divided by 2. So here you are getting 30. Again 30 is to be divided by 2. 15. 15 is to be divided by 2. Sorry, 15 can't be divided by 2. So divide by 3. So here you are getting what? 5. So students, the factors of the prime factorization of 60. 2, 2, 3 and 5. Right? Students, you want to find out LCM. LCM of 90 and 60. Okay? LCM stand for least common multiple. LCM stand for least common multiple. So first of all, you will have to take the common multiple. 3 is to be common multiple, 5 is also common multiple and 2 is common multiple. So writing these things, first of all 2, 3 and 5. Now students, you will have to write the remaining numbers, remaining factors 3 and 2. Okay, so students, getting the multiplication of these numbers 6, 6 5 is a 30, 30 3 is a 90, 90 2 is a 180. So LCM will be students 180. Now HCF. HCF of 90 and 60. So highest common factor. You don't need to write the remaining numbers which are not common between these two. So students, to find out HCF, you will have to write over here 2 from here, from these two pairs of 3, one time 3 and here is 5. So students, 3 2 is a 6, 6 5 is a 30, right? Okay. Now students, considering the second question to find out LCM and HCF, suppose the second question is you having the number 108 and 24. 108 and 24. You want to find out LCM and HCF of these integers. So again, doing the prime factorization using tree factor, 108. 108 is to be divided by 2. So here you are getting what? 5, 4, 54. Again divide by 2. Here you are getting 27. 27 is to be divided by 3. Here you are getting 9. And 9 is to be divided by 3. Here you are getting 3 again. So students, 108 can be written as 2, 2, 3 into 3 into 3. Right? Similar way, doing the factorization of 24. So 2. It goes 12 times. Again divide by 2, it goes 6 times, 6 is divided by 2, it goes 3 times, right students? So 24 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now finding the LCM of 108 and 24. First of all, see the common multiples. 2 and 3 over here. So writing these things, 2 and 3. Now students, you will have to write the remaining part also, remaining factors of these numbers. So remaining factors are what? 3 and 3, and here is 2. Okay students, now multiplying the factors here, 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12, 12 3's are 36, 36 3's are 108, and 108 2's are 216. So students, the LCM is 216. Similarly, we will find out HCF, the highest common factor. The highest common factor. We will not write the remaining terms which are not paired with the factor of other integers. So students, the highest common factor here is 2, here is 2 and 3. So 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. So HCF is 12. Okay. Now finally, we are going to practice one more questions. Just keep patience students. The question are, suppose 24, 15 and 36. Right? We want to find out LCM and HCF more than two integers. Okay, students, here you will have to do the same process. Go for the tree factors just to find out LCM. See the common multiples and write the multiples which are not common. And in HCF, just you will have to write the common multiples. Right? So, students, here you can see that by the tree factor, 24 can be factorized. Divide by 2, here we are getting students 12. Now divide by 2, it goes 6 times. Divide by 2, it goes 3 times. Similarly, 15. So 15 divide by 3, it goes 5 times. And 36. Now students, about 36, divide by 2, it goes 18 times. And 18 divided by 2, it goes 9 times. 9 divided by 3, it goes 3 times. Now students, writing the factors of 24, 15 and 36 over here. So 24, 2 and 3. Similarly, writing the factors of 15, 3 into 5, right? Writing the factor of 36, so 2 2 3 and 3, right? So students, we want to find out LCM of these integers 24 15 and 36. So first of all, writing the common multiples and common factors. So which are the common factor in all the integers? First of all, writing 3, right? Right, students? So writing 3 over here. Okay. Now 2 is common between 24 and 36. So writing 2. Right? Again 2 is common. 2. Now students, you can see that 2, 5 and 3 are not common multiples. So again multiplying 2, 5, 3 and 5. Now getting the multiples are 6, 6 2's are 12, 12 2's are 24, 24 3's are 72, 72 5's are 360, right? So LCM will be 360. Now we will find out HCF, HCF, highest common factor. So what are the common factor in all these three integers? Only 3, students. So HCF of 24, 15 and 36 is 3. Okay students, here we are completing today's video lessons. If you having any doubt in any topic from any class, just give the suggestion in the comment box. I'm promising that I will make the video of that topic. I hope you have understood this video lessons. If you having any doubt in any lessons in any topic, just suggest in the comment box. If you have not subscribed my channel, just subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Okay, students, meet you once again. Thank you so much.